Hello everyone, welcome to another video. My name is David and today we are talking about Casper, CSPR. But before we talk about anything else, I have an announcement. On any social media app, I will never message you first. There's a fake account of me going around on Twitter with actually more followers, around 2k followers. I won't message you first. If you want to make sure it's me where I'm responding to you, go to my YouTube. It's pretty hard to replicate my YouTube, and then actually go to the links available in the About section, or just go to the links down below to make sure it's actually my account. But today we're talking about Casper CSPR. Barely talk about this crypto on the channel, so at the start of the video, a little recap what it actually is and what makes it different from other layer ones within this space, because it's a very important component of that, which is upgradable smart contracts. There's also store of values in this space. I believe CSPR Casper is a wealth multiplier on top of giving you returns on the actual asset and profit of price going up. Staking is involved. We will talk about that later on in the video. A lot of value. Stay around to the end. Without further ado, here we go. Okay, so firstly, we have a reminder here. So Casper is an enterprise level blockchain. When it comes to other blockchains in comparison, they are very niche technology, take years to learn. Within Casper, you will be building within weeks. And currently there's a problem right now with enterprises having lack of control over smart contracts. Well, Casper, last time I checked, is the only blockchain to have upgradable smart contracts. So, which makes it feature-proof, but enterprises can now add new features and make bug fixes to their on-chain code. And this isn't something to mess about with. You know, the network itself was developed by ex-Ethereum programmers and coders from Microsoft and Google, and I think Adobe as well. You know, big, big names involved with this project. First piece I want to talk about is IPWE, a case study. So Casper blockchain is the game changer for businesses and governments managing patents. How Casper Labs helped IPWE pioneer a better way to protect, license, and trade intellectual property. So with Casper Labs, they're making patents traceable and tradable, and going forward, millions of IPWE patents as NFTs are going to be minted on Casper Network moving towards 2023. That is going to be huge, and this made this whole process possible, where we saw Casper Labs and IBM create the first atomic cross-chain swap of fungible non-fungible tokens. So 2,000 plus companies can swap their assets from Hyperledger Fabric to the Casper Network, and IPWE was one of the first. And so in conclusion, by using the Casper blockchain, they have improved the registration patent process. So now they can collect, secure, track patent data. Very interesting. Here we have a little clip that I want to play that goes into more detail.
IPWE has been mentioned a lot. They're obviously at alpha right now. So in the coming weeks, they are to launch a couple million patents, which is super exciting because...
Wait. One patent is one NFT, so they're going to mint 1 million patents on Casper blockchain?
Correct.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm serious, yeah. And that's just a start, just to be clear, just a start. So in the coming weeks, that's something that's super exciting and obviously a game changer because, you know, with these patents, you know, you're really turning a cost-centric asset into a revenue-generating asset because it can be trade, it could be licensed, etc. So that's one project that I can definitely talk about. And then I would say what else we can say is, I think, you know, with Davos coming up in January during the World Economic Forum, we're going to have a very big presence again there this year. So we'll be making some great announcements there in terms of things that we're working on. But you do have to remember, you know, that the timeline it takes, obviously, to do these projects, be it a POC, MVP, or production, it takes time. So we're not just going to make an announcement at, you know, an early stage of a project. We want to do it with a big impact.
And one important part to capture from that clip there is, you know, a big presence at Davos. Now, they were at Davos 2022. Along with leaders from LCX, ALBT, and it was CSPR, three low caps that we talk about the channel. I wouldn't consider CSPR too much a low cap anymore, but definitely was more of a low cap. Now, attending, you know, Davos, we see, you know, leaders, prominent leaders from Fortune 500 companies, leading blockchain firms, governments involved, right? Usually the majority of billionaires are there, you know, in the hundreds and whatnot, and, you know, heads of state. And here are some of the speakers confirmed for links of Coinbase, Bitcoin Foundation, Amazon, CoinDesk, IBM, NASDAQ, lots and lots involved in the IPWE president. Another clip here, I'm not going to play it, but they were asked, is there any partnership agreement between this entity? And she says she can't disclose any information, but there is 45 plus NDAs, and the majority of them are Fortune 500 and 100 companies. Realize how insane that is. An NDA being a legal document, an agreement between two parties agreeing not to disclose any sensitive information over the course, over the period of them doing business together. Fortune 500 companies within energy, retail, public sector, manufacturing and supply chain, financial services, healthcare. This is huge. At least should make you keep an eye on Casper for the future approaching 2023. Also, we talked about a crypto winter with Lehman Baird, you know, hiring, building during the bear market. Well, hiring is very important for other crypto projects. Here is one new hire, Ross Mackay. We can see here, Chief Operating Officer, December 2022, and his previous experience at Soldo, Dropbox, and Accuture. And it seems we are in a building process with Casper. We are hiring. Not too much hype around, you know, these hires going on here. And also when these NDAs are over, when actual Fortune 500 companies' names are released, I feel that there'll be a lot of media attention on CSPR and a lot of FOMO into this asset going forward. Also, a beautiful mind map by XX. Not much to really add. We can see here with Casper, security, programmability, scalability, decentralization, privacy, partnerships involved, grant program. But here we can see the actual utility of CSPR. So rewards validators. Pays for computations of transfruit stable gas fees and serves as a medium of EXBTW/network participants. So there's utility for the actual token. And we talked about it in previous videos. And here we can actually stake. So node one is full. You can stake with node two around 9 to 10% APY. Here we have a calculate your earnings calculator. So you want to put $1,000 in for the year. You would, at the end of it, have 3,300 CSPR, and that's obviously considering you beat the same price point. This is a fantastic system because you can see if you are on track with where you want to be, maybe in profits with this asset. For me, it's not on the top of my list, so my profits are not high as in mine with maybe QNT, for example, so I can see how much I'm putting every single month, calculate it for the year, maybe calculate it over 2-3 years. If my profit is up to my standards that I have in mind, if not, add more. If it's too much, take away less, put into something else like LCX or ALBT. I will leave this staking rewards calculator down below. And lastly, a video, 100 million users on the Casper network. I think this is very possible and beyond because not only is Casper network allowing developers to easily build their own decentralized applications, it's allowing businesses, consumers to leverage blockchain technology. That is pretty much it for today's video. Just a little update with what is going on, because I saw this tweet here and I was like, I have to talk about this, you know. So in summary, today's video, we talked about Casper. What separates it from other layer ones is that it has upgradable smart contracts. Also, a lot of case studies, use cases, and more to go actually go into. This is just one that I have selected. You know, huge presence we've heard at Davos, you know, World Economic Forum event. Very, very important. You know, billionaires are there. The money is there. Increases the likelihood of adoption, whether you ethically agree with Davos, whatever's going on there or not. Also, staking, very, very interesting. Involved hiring, this is a really interesting asset. Is it one of my top holds? No, it isn't. Could it be in the future? Possibly. It is not in my multi-million dollar plan, but I couldn't include every single crypto. You know, I couldn't, there's other cryptos that I hold like ALBT, CSPR, more that are not on that list. Let me know down below, do you think CSPR is a decent hold? Do you hold any? Let me know down below. But if you made this fun video, thank you very much for watching. Please leave a like down below, and I will see you guys in the next one.
The goal of Casper Labs really is to onboard the next 100 million users onto blockchain, right? It's a very ambitious goal. We believe that will happen by working with enterprises, through enterprises, that users will adopt blockchain technology by working with companies and products and services and offerings that they use today. And so working with those companies to help them adopt blockchain technology is what we're all about. We like to focus very much on the CTOs and CIOs of the top Fortune 500s. or startups that are looking to build new products and services that use blockchain technology, these are the core folks that we're really interested in helping. I think Casper Labs solves a really important problem from the world, and that really is scaling out the adoption and use of blockchain technology so that consumers can use it safely. And we believe that's going to happen through enterprises, through products and services that people use today, every day. We're going to do that by enabling enterprises to use the technology. And so they're used to adopting brand new technology by working with a professional services team that trains them, that holds their hand, that guides them, and to build those products that consumers can use, that use blockchain technology on the back end, right? So it's an enabling technology. We don't know we're using cloud when we use cloud. We don't know that we're using HTTP when we use the internet. And similarly, we don't need to know that we're using blockchain technology to reap the benefits of it. So our goal is to work with them to build those products and features and functionalities so that consumers can benefit from the tech itself.